Hey friends, it's Corey from Hey Let's Make Stuff, and in today's video, we are talking all about Cricut fonts. This video is an extensive overview of the Cricut text tool, including fonts, sizing, styling, and more. This video will help you create more professional text in your Cricut projects. If there is something you want to know about text, we will definitely cover it in this video. There's a lot to learn, so let's get started. So here we are on a blank Cricut canvas. Adding text is super easy. All you have to do is click text over here in the left-hand toolbar, and it will insert a text box for you. If you click into the text box, you can change the text. You can cut this as is, just hit make it and cut it in whatever material you have. But of course, there are so many other ways to manipulate fonts in Cricut Design Space, and that's what this video is about. So let's start with this actual text box. If you click out of the text box, you'll see that a bunch of handles appear around the text box. The corner handles here make it bigger and smaller, so you can change the size. There's also side handles. Now these side handles change the text wrapping. So if you have several words and you want them to wrap onto several lines, you can make this a little bit smaller and you'll see that your text wraps to a second line. I don't use this feature very much, but it is nice when you have longer text so you don't have to hit a hard return every time you want a new line. When you have the text selected, you'll notice that a font menu appears at the top. When you don't have your text selected, that menu disappears. There's a lot happening in this menu. We have your font dropdown, your style dropdown. You can change the font size, letter spacing, line spacing, alignment, curve, and there's an advanced menu as well. We will cover all of these things in this video, but let's start with this font dropdown. Inside this font dropdown is another robust menu. There are a lot of things happening in this menu, but it's basically where you can change the font that you are using. There are two types of fonts that you can use. There are Cricut fonts, which you can see here. I can scroll down and see all of these amazing Cricut fonts. I have to say that Cricut used to have very lame fonts, but over the last year, they've gotten way more fonts and there's a lot to choose from. If you click on system, you'll see fonts that are actually uploaded to your own computer. Let's look at how to do that. On a PC, look in your downloads for the zip folder of your font. Double-click the folder to open it. From here, you may see a second folder, open that folder, and then you'll see all of the fonts. Double-click the font you want to install. Then you'll click Install, and your computer will install your font. On a Mac, if you've downloaded a font, it will usually be in your Downloads folder, and it will usually be in a zip. So go ahead and double-click the zip, and this will show you what fonts are inside the zip. There's two fonts here, so I'm going to click on the first one, and this will open up the font book. And here you can click Install Font, and it will be installed on your computer. Now, there's a glitch lately that's driving me crazy where you won't be able to see some of your fonts. They'll just be these blank spaces. It's really quite annoying because, you know, maybe you want to use these files, but I don't know what Adrift Bold looks like without seeing a preview. But you can, for the most part, click on these and you will be able to change your font. So this is what that Adrift Bold font looks like. I can't see it in that drop-down menu, but I can see it on my canvas. Hopefully they'll get this glitch fixed soon. Let's talk about Cricut fonts versus system fonts. Generally, they behave the same, but there are a few quirks. So a lot of Cricut fonts do have styles. So if I choose a Cricut font here, this Alyssa stencil script, it will have a drop down here where I can also change this to a writing font, which we will talk about later. I just wanted to let you know that Cricut fonts are the ones that have the styles associated with them. The other big difference is that Cricut fonts are designed to be cut well. They've been tested by the Cricut team, and you shouldn't have any issues when cutting. System fonts, however, have not been tested. So if I search for a grunge font, I have several here. You'll notice that none of the previews come up. But let's say I chose this Standby Slab grunge font. Now you'll see that this looks like it's okay. But if I make it larger, you'll see that it has all of these little pieces to cut out. I'm going to zoom in here. Now, if you imagine your Cricut trying to cut out every single one of these grungy little pieces, I mean, the Cricut's amazing, but it is going to fail miserably, and it's also going to probably take a very long time to try and cut this grungy font. So when you're cutting system fonts, you definitely want to be aware of the font you are using. You don't want to find a font that is grungy or has really rough edges, because your Cricut will struggle to cut those fonts. Look for smooth fonts with thicker strokes, and you'll be just fine. Back here in the system menu, you can search for a font by name. You can do this both in the Cricut tab or in the system tab. And you can also sort by language. So let's say you speak Japanese. You'll see that there are Japanese fonts. Some of these don't actually have any results. For example, Chinese has no results right now. I don't know if this is a glitch or they don't have any Chinese fonts, but hopefully they'll fix this soon. So if you are Chinese, you can use the characters that you want. Next, we have this kerned fonts checkbox. Now, the word kerned here is not exactly how it's used in graphic design. To kern a font in graphic design means to individually space each letter so that it looks good visually. So a lot of times, for example, a capital A and then a capital Y will look a little far apart just because of the way that the A slants down and the Y slants up. And kerning those two letters would be moving those two letters closer together so that they look better. That's not exactly what's happening here in Cricut Design Space. Kerned fonts just means that these are better letter-spaced fonts. So let's turn off this kerned fonts, and I want to search for a font called Aphrodite. Now you can see here, this is not particularly good letter spacing, right? The reason for this is before kerned fonts, each of the letters in Cricut Design Space is its own text box. So if you can imagine a square being around this letter H, this is why that E is not tucked underneath that tail up here from the H, because each of these letters is its own box, which creates a very unattractive letter spacing like this. However, kern fonts have sort of fixed this problem. So if we go back to just kern fonts and we choose a kerned font like Belinda, you'll notice that each of the letters is sort of tucked under where it should be. And generally, you don't have to fix a lot of this letter spacing, which is awesome. I am going to go into how to fix letter spacing just in case you want to choose one of those non-kerned fonts. But generally, kerned fonts have this better letter spacing. But if you want to make individual edits, you'll need to use some of the more advanced tools. Finally, in this font menu, there are filters over here on the right. Now, there are quite a few filters here to let you choose the fonts you want to use. So, for example, you can choose multi-layer fonts, and I will say that most of the multi-layer fonts are not kerned. So if you want one of those, you probably have to uncheck that kerned box. A multi-layer font, when you choose it, you'll see here, has more than one layer here, and you can turn this on, and you can see now that there are two layers to this font. That's what's meant by multi-layer fonts. You can also choose single layer fonts, which is most fonts. You can choose writing fonts. Now, these are Cricut fonts that have a specific writing style. So if I choose here this BFC Backyard Garden, it will show me the regular font. But if I choose the writing style, you'll be able to write it with a pen or foil it or use one of the other tools like that. You can also choose stencil fonts, which are really helpful if you want to make a particular stencil project. It will have these little cutouts so you won't lose any of the interiors of your letters, as well as choosing free fonts, purchases, and downloads. So free fonts are fonts, obviously, that Cricut doesn't charge for and you can use on your own. Purchases are fonts that you've purchased, and downloads are fonts you've saved for offline use, which I will go into in just a minute. Notice that the system tab doesn't have any of those filters and it doesn't have the language dropdown. It doesn't allow you to save your system fonts for offline use, for example, because they already exist on your computer and you do not need to be online to access them. There are two more things to look at in this font dropdown. The first is this little download icon. So this is where you save fonts for offline use. So let's say I wanted to save this Alphabet Soup for offline use here. You just click download and this will be saved for offline use. Then you will also be able to see that when you go here to downloads. These are fonts that I've saved for offline use that I can use if I don't have internet access. You'll also see a little bookmark tab. So let's say I want to save that Alphabet Soup font to bookmark it so I can find it easily next time. Then I can go to my bookmarks up here and all the fonts that I've bookmarked will be saved here. You can actually bookmark your system fonts as well. Okay, we are back to our canvas and let's talk a little bit more about writing fonts. So like I said, only Cricut fonts have writing styles. So for example, if I choose writing here, it will change it to a writing font. And this looks like how I would actually write it with a pen. It's got just a single stroke and I would write it just like this. Now, if you choose a system font here, like if I choose Fifth Avenue, you'll see that it actually outlines the font when it's in a writing style. This is not how I would normally write. Obviously, I don't outline all of my letters. So if you're looking for a font that specifically has that writing style where it's a single line, you'll want to make sure you're using a Cricut font with a writing style. You can also make changes to your font using the operation menu. So to start up here, if you click this box, you can change the color of your font. You can change it to any of the default colors, or you can come down here and use the color picker or put in a hex code. You can also change the operation of your font. Depending on your machine, you have a lot of options here. If I have my Maker 3 selected and I go to operation, I can change it to, for example, write with a pen, and it will outline it. I can change it to foil it, or I can change it to engrave it. There's quite a few options in there. I can even change it to a print then cut file. Let's continue along this menu. Again, we have the style dropdown, and some Cricut fonts, in addition to having that writing style, also have things like bold and italic that you can choose. So this makes that same font bold and italic. Next up, you have font size. So if you know exactly that you want this to be 300, you can make it that size. Font size can be a little misleading because what is 300 points in one font will be enormous in another font and very small in another font, but it does give you a general sense of the size of your font. Next here is letter spacing. So this is the distance between your actual letters. And it starts with 0, but if I change it to 5, you'll see that my letter spacing is very spaced out. And if I change it to -1, you'll see that my font has gotten much closer together. So if you have a font that seems like it needs a little breathing room, you can bump up the letter spacing a little bit. Then there's line spacing. So let's go ahead and type a second hello here. We have two hellos. Let's make it a little bit smaller so we can see it a little better. Just like the name says, line spacing changes the amount of space between your two lines. The default is 1. 1 what? I don't really know, but it's 1. And you can go ahead and make that smaller and your text will get closer together. Or you can make it bigger, like if I put 2 here and your text will be farther away. For the alignment tools, I'm using two different words here. And I just wanted to point out that this is what I'm talking about when I'm talking about kerning. This is technically a kerned font, but there is so much space here on either side of this Y that I wouldn't want to cut this goodbye as is. I will want to fix that. And we will go into how to do that here in a few minutes. But right now we are in the alignment tools. So there are quite a few tools in this dropdown. First, you have these three tools that will align your text. So left aligns it to the left, center aligns it center, and right aligns it right. That all makes sense. Now, if you remember from the beginning of this lesson, I talked about these text handles at the top and sides of your text. So if I make this a little bit bigger here, you can see that it tried to wrap that E onto that line. So let's go ahead here. Now this text is sitting sort of in the middle of this text box, and that's when these other alignment tools come into play. So you can align things to the top of your text box, to the center of your text box, and to the bottom of your text box. You can also turn the text wrap on or off. So right now it's on, which means that if I make this smaller, my text will wrap to another line. If you turn it off, all it will do is resize the size of your text box. So if I turn it off here, you'll see that I basically have the text box the size of my text. That doesn't change whether or not it wraps, however. If I still grab this handle, I can make that text wrap. And then I can reset the text box basically by turning the wrap off. Next up in our tools is curve. This is a fairly basic tool, but it allows you to curve text around a center axis. So if I click curve here, you can change the slider to make your text curve down or curve up. And you can actually curve it all the way into a full circle, which looks a little silly with the word hello, but you get the point. Now let's talk a little bit more about these advanced tools. These advanced tools come in really handy when you're working with a font that is not kerned, like this font, Pen and Ink. You used to have to fix fonts like this all the time using these tools, but with kerned fonts, you don't have to do it quite as often. However, I think they're really helpful to know so that you can fix things like that Y in goodbye in the last example. So here I have Make Today Awesome, and let's be real, it looks terrible. This is a script font, and all of these little tails should be overlapping. Like, why is there so much space here next to the T, and this Y is floating off on its own? We can make this so much better using these advanced tools. So to start, we can ungroup to lines. That means each of these lines is its own separate layer over here in the layers panel on the right. You can see here that I can click each one individually, which means that I can move things like this. We can make today awesome. And that's like a little bit better, right? Like at least the lines aren't crazy spaced. It looks a lot better, but obviously we can make this even better. So I'm gonna zoom in here. Now you can actually move each of these individual letters. This is a script font, so those tails, for the most part, should overlap. So for example, I'm gonna move all of today over here and I'm gonna overlap each of the tails where it should be. This is how you get a font to look exactly how it should be and how you can fix text that doesn't look quite right. So we've got today, let's make it awesome. We've got this, just move everything over. And there's no perfect way to do this. It's really just based on how you think it looks best. And then we'll move over here for make, like this. Now, say you think make is just a little bit, you can select all your fonts and move them up. Now let's talk about actually making our file. So if you've separated all of your letters like this, you need to weld or unite all of your tools. So I'm using an older version of Cricut Design Space here, which only has weld, but if you have the newer version of Cricut Design Space, you'll be able to unite these, which is a very similar tool. It just allows you to still make changes after you've welded it. So I'm going to weld this here, and it will turn it into a single welded layer in the layers panel on the right. Then you can make it, and everything will show up on the mat as you have it. Until recently, you needed to weld any script font if you wanted to cut it as one piece. With a recent update, however, you now don't have to weld your text before you cut it. So I have the word hello here in this Alyssa Stencil script. If I hit make it, it will automatically weld it on my mat for me. This is super awesome. It just saves you a step. Don't have to worry about it. One final thing about text before we wrap up this video. If you can't find a font you like, always look in the images. So if I go here to images and I type in the word hello, for example, there are more than 1,000 results for the word hello. You get these sort of swooshy, pretty hellos. You get this sort of cute hello, layered hello. There are a lot more options here than just working with text. And that's it. That's all about Cricut fonts in Design Space. If you have any questions or you're struggling in any way with your fonts, go ahead and leave me a comment. If you found this video helpful, I'd really appreciate a like. If you want more Cricut Design Space content like this, hit subscribe, and I'll see y'all next week.